Every single lab here at LJI uses flow cytometry in some way. I'm Cheryl Kim, Senior Director of Flow Cytometry at the Jolla Institute for Immunology. Cytometry actually stands for the measurement of a cell, so that's what cyto means. And then flow is the method in which these measurements are made. So flow, it has to be in some type of fluid. And we actually use lasers and optics to identify some type of physical or chemical characteristic on the cell. What is cool about flow is it's a high-throughput method. So there is no other method where you could get the data live. We can go above 10,000 events per second, even up to like 15,000 events per second. So we're talking we can go through at least 20 million cells an hour. So it actually places the cells into a single cell flow suspension, and then there's lasers that come and hit it. And at each point, if there's color there, it actually detects a signal and then sends it back to the software. You can see this instantaneously. I mean, it's faster than you can even say a word, right? And you can get all of this information live. What's exciting is that we really do have a lot of support for getting the latest technology. And so we have collaborations with major companies that we buy equipment from. So BD Biosciences has been in the field for a long time. And then Cytec Biosciences, they develop the spectral analyzers. We invest money in new technology to be more cutting edge. And so we have purchased at least 3 early access units, meaning that it's like post beta. But really, at that point, it's past prototype. But when we get it, it's not a fully developed product, almost, right? And so it usually takes like 2 to 4 years to be a good product. And so we've actually invested and taken the chance of doing that, but just to give our users capability and our labs capability that no other place has. We had one sorter that we bought the first one of. Our other sorter, which is called an S6, that one is a high parameter sorter, so it can detect up to 28 colors at a time. And we just got 2 more. And then we also have an Aurora cell sorter. We get to work with the companies directly, and we have feedback with what is working and what's not working. So say for the S6, we purchased that in 2019. It took several revisions of different components, including lasers, and we give them feedback that's really important to make the product a better product. We received $1.17 million from the Conrad Pervez Foundation for instrumentation in 2022. Also, Shane received an award from the Gates Foundation in 2019 to purchase about, I want to say, over 60% of that first cell sorter. And we had the first one installed in the US and the 4th internationally. With cell sorting, we can actually physically separate out the population from a total sample. And so this also happens just as fast. So say if there's a population that's 0.01% of the frequency of the total sample, we can actually physically remove the population and they can do further studies. So most of our cell sorting experiments go directly to RNA-seq, where they can study at the gene level. For cell sorting, for instance, it actually got invented from inkjet printing, because after the cells get interrogated from the laser, there's a vibration that takes place. So it actually like breaks up the stream so that it forms droplets. And so the cell is actually encapsulated in a droplet. So by the time it detects a cell, like you can actually make all of the gates that you want, like I'm interested in this population of cells. And then we can send it back to the machine and it actually like gives the drop a charge. So we can take like up to 6 populations at the same time. And so say if the frequency is 0.01%, if we were to run it back through the machine, then usually our purity is like above 97%. So we can really isolate and purify a population, which you can't really do that with any other technology. We get the data, you can say, oh, this population is here, this population disappeared. You can even be as specific as, these are the cells that are targeting this specific antigen. So say if it's like they're trying to fight against flu, COVID, whatever disease it is, we can actually detect that cell. So like we're talking one in a million. And here at LJI, everybody studies rare cell types. So for instance, Alex's lab, they study T cells and T cell immune response. And Shane's lab, they study B cells and T cells. And so there are different cell types that have a different role in protecting the body. And in order to study these cell types, you have to be able to characterize them from a total population. And so we can take any samples, it could be from blood, it could be from biopsies, even like sputum from the lung. Also in mouse disease models, you can take any type of immune organ, for instance, spleen, lymph nodes, anything that creates like an immune response or vaccination response even. And you can basically isolate the cells. So if we get tissue, you can mash them up and put them into a single cell suspension. And we actually add very specific antibodies that are specific to these cell types that are fluorescently labeled with a specific color. So there's specialized colors that these machines can actually detect and see. And so with this, we can tag several different proteins on the surface of a cell that are tagged with these colors. And these machines allow us to identify these specific cell types, but also study their function in the disease model. And so we can say, oh, these cells are activated in whatever tissue we're looking at or sample that we're looking at. And it tells us a lot about the disease model that they're studying. Since we're an immunology institute, we help characterize and identify cells. And immune cells are super important in immune responses. And so here, every single lab that studies any type of disease, cancer, the immune system is super important in fighting this off. And so in order to do that, we have to identify the cells that are important in creating an immune response. And so here, they study several different cell types that could be shared across different diseases. But without this, they can't make the discoveries that they need to do further experiments. And so every single lab here at LJI uses flow cytometry in some way.